Hello everyone, welcome to my channel Lecture Notes. So today I'll be explaining a poem, Revolving Days, which is written by David Miloff. So I would like to tell you the basic of this poem. Here the poet has addressed this poem to his lover, and now they are ex-lover, the relationship is no more, and now he is nostalgic and thinking about the past memories, that how he had changed his lifestyle for the lover, and now he is imagining that the lover will be with someone else while he is stuck in time, and he is thinking about her while she might have moved on. So starting from the line, that year I had nowhere to go. I fell in love, a mistake, of course, but it lasted and has lasted. Nowhere to go, it highlights that he had no option and nowhere else to be, and he made no effort, and it came to him by chance or luck. So clearly he says that nowhere to go, that I didn't have anything to do, and what I did in that period of time, I fell in love, a mistake. Mistake here reference to again that it happened with the flow and he had no intention to be in love as well as get out of love. But it lasted and it has lasted, which shows that the love and relationship did not last, but the memory has lasted for a long, long time. The duration of the relationship did not last, but the memory is something which has turned out to be the memory of forever. The old tug at the heart. So here the tug can be seen as the tug of war game, where the poet is constantly pushing and pulling his love, emotions and feelings, where he is seen that he's seen in a condition of confusion and dilemma, where he sees himself at tug at war of his emotions, that whether to love him, whether to get out of the love or not, but in the present he is not with the lover. The grace unasked for, urgencies that boom under the pocket of a shirt. So he tells that the grace unasked, that how people go beyond their limits, how they act gracefully and then follow the path of love. Urgencies that boom under the pocket of a shirt. Here, the pocket of shirt here has been referred to the heart. That is, his heart is still full of love. He has same feelings, but his love hasn't changed, but the situation, the relationship has changed. What I remember is the color of the shirts. I had bought them as an experiment in ways of seeing himself. Then the lover tells that how he had changed his lifestyle, his clothing, his wardrobe, because the author shows that he was in love and changed himself willingly at length for the love. Example, he bought and wore shirts which he had never bought. The idea that love makes you cross limits, that how he was ready, willingly changing himself, making an effort. Here now he was making an effort to impress the lover, therefore he had bought a variety of different new shirts to impress her. Hoping to catch in a window as I passed what I was to be in my new life as a lover. So he's telling that how he had changed his life, but right now in the present also he hopes in past he was hoping that the lover was impressed and their relationship will smoothly go on. In the next paragraph you will see that how he is remembering in the past, that he is remembering what used to happen, but in the present he is only remembering, but he is still satisfied with his present. One mint green, one pink, the third called Ivy League, tan with darker stripes, my first button-down collar, we never write. So he's telling the colors of the shirt, my first button-down colors. He was ready to change a lifestyle and start over a new life with his lover, that he was ready to do everything. He was ready to cross every limit for the lover. But we never write, that we did not made any commitment. We never write also shows that we are not in talking terms anymore, or we were never in a written commitment that our love will last forever. But sometimes knotting my tie at a mirror, one of these selves I had expected steps into a room. So how these last three lines shows that how his memories has a strong grasp over him, that how he hoped and how he visualized things, that while he's doing his work, he still hopes that from nowhere the lover will come back to him. Still now he had expected that the lover will come. How his memories of the past are quite strong, so much so that he is able to depict moments from his love aware and clarity and poignant emotion. So it can, a reader can completely see that how he is revolving or moving in his past memories of his lover. So these three lines also shows, it can also mean that the poet still has expected that the lover will come back or the love will be reciprocated as he had. Moving to the next lines, in the next room you are waiting. We have not yet taken back the life we promised to pour into each other's mouths forever and forever. While I choose between changes to surprise you. So here the past comes back to greet him. While he is in the bathroom looking in the mirror and he recalls the time they spent together and the promise they made. These have fallen to the wayside as has his relationship. So he is reminiscing in the past, that he is nostalgic about the past and he is hugging the past while he is in present. He is in the present but he is still thinking about his past memories and his lover. You will notice that the forever thing, the forever is in bracket and the second forever is broken, which shows that the words come in bracket and that how forever was a small period of time and in present it doesn't exist, that it doesn't have a doesn't hold any value in the present. Therefore this line forever and forever is in bracket and the second forever is broken, that how forever is not a permanent commitment and it is for a shorter period of time. While I choose between the changes to surprise you, that how he chose everything for the lover and how he had changed everything for the lover. Revolving days, my heart in my mouth again, I'm writing this for you. You will notice from each other mouth to my heart in my mouth in the same paragraph. This is the present. That is the present. They were so much indulged that they almost were together every time, which means from each other mouth that they were almost mentally, physically together every time. But now thinking about those moments made him nervous. Therefore, heart in my mouth. Earlier, they were in each other mouth. But right now, his heart in his mouth shows that how thinking about those past memories makes him anxious. I'm writing this for you. Clearly, he's addressing to the ex-lover and saying that this poem is dedicated or addressed to you. Now, in this paragraph, the name of the poem is written, Revolving Days, which highlights his nostalgic emotion, which exhibits the taste of past in present, that how he is moving or memorizing all the things about the past, which highlights his emotion of nostalgia and exhibits how he is hugging the past in the present. Wherever you are, whoever is staring at your blue eyes, it is me, I'm still here. It is me, I'm still here. In the first line, it shows that lover is thinking that the ex-lover has, the poet is thinking basically the ex-lover has moved on while he is the one who is stuck. Therefore, he says that whosoever is staring into your blue eyes, that you might have moved on, but I am the one who is still here, who is still stuck in the past, who is still stuck in the memories. So it is me, I'm still here, that he is still holded in the past, he is still grounded in the past, he hasn't moved out from the past, but believes that the lover might have moved on from him. Things, situation, love, emotions have changed, but at times he's stuck in the memories of the lover and the relationship. But he has a confidence that the lover, the ex-lover has moved on and now she'll be sitting with somebody else, she'll be spending the time with someone else And the reference that someone else is staring into your blue eyes, that how he remembers everything and how he is visualizing everything, giving a reader an image that how she has a blue eyes and now she is sitting with someone else. No, don't worry. I won't appear out of the old time to discomfort you. In the next lines, he confirms that he is not obsessed lover and will not harm, disturb her in any way. He confirmed that he isn't a roadside lover who will make her life miserable, that there are various kind of lover who tries to make the life miserable when the relationship is over, like the threats of suicide and the various threats when the relationship comes to an end. So he says that I'm content with my present, and I'm not here, I'm not remembering my past to discomfort you. And no, at this distance, I'm not holding my breath for a reply. At this distance, referring to physical as well as mental distance, that we have created a distance over period of time or over our breakup or our relationship. I'm holding my breath here refers to that he doesn't have any expectations from the lover. He doesn't want to tarnish the present, which implies that he's satisfied with the present condition, although he's writing for her but doesn't expect anything from her. So holding my breath, that I'm not waiting for your reply. This is poem is addressed to the lover, but he is not expecting anything. He is only sharing his old memories and nothing else. So thank you for watching this video.